This little presentation will be about a database which we use in Egis, and it's based on ChemAxon platform. And it runs for 5 years. It has been running for 5 years. This is a complex database which needs many work to bring together. So there is the JChem platform, which makes possible to store chemical structures and reactions and to search them. There is a need for integration. This was done by ComInnex. Here are the excellent programmers. And Egis provided the users. The ChemAxon components of this database. Okay, so JChem is the main thing, storing and searching chemical structures. Marvin, it's necessary because we have to draw chemical structures. Both Marvin Desktop and Marvin GS. You know the story about Marvin GS. The browser providers declared war against Java applets, and this resulted in developing Marvin GS, which runs on JavaScript code, and therefore it's under the complete supervision of the browser. The next component is standardizer. This is a common problem. You can draw different ways, certain groups, and standardizer can be defined or programmed to transform them to a unique style. Partitioning plugin is also a useful component. It can calculate pKa values and logP values and combine them, for example, to a logD diagram. And these logD diagrams are very useful for chromatographers. And at last but not least, the structure to name plugin. This means automatic name generation, which is done every time when a compound is modified or registered into the database. Our experience that this module is highly efficient. I never found mistakes with it. IUPAC names are never the same when you compare IUPAC names from different sources. There are dialects. But within the framework of its own dialect, this structure to name functionality was always correct. There were some very sophisticated examples, very complex compounds with metal ions which it couldn't name, but also Bayerstein couldn't name it. So it's not a big problem. Not a big thing. This is the common database structure. We have chemical structures, chemical reactions. They are interconnected because chemical reactions contain structures. If a reaction is realized, it's called a production, and the substances are stored in containers. Containers can be connected with production set with chemical structures both. And every container can be connected with analytical results. And the work is organized into projects, and this will have some significance on a later slide. There are some other functionality which is not connected to chemical structures. It's a common alphanumeric data connection. So the database handles reagent containers. Every container has a unique barcode. Location is stored. Quantities are tracked continuously. There is a procurement system. Safety data are stored. H and P phrases, GHS symbols, label printing functionality, MSDS sheets. And there are the so-called controlled substances. And here I mentioned that ChemAxon has a special service called compliance checker. You can check for a compound whether some legal restriction exists on it. And the database has also electronic laboratory notebook functionalities, so tracking of starting materials, physical constants, analytics. It's bilingual, Hungarian and English, and it can make hard copies, which are accepted by legal authorities. A little problem about stereochemistry. Let's take an example. Here, this molecule has a stereogenic center, asymmetric center. And at first, let us assume that we prepared it in a racemic form. Then, with the enhanced stereochemistry option, we can assign a flag and flag, and this means it is a racemic compound. A problem arises when we resolve it. Then we get a left rotatory and a right rotatory form. And when we draw it, we have to use this OR flag. But the OR flag is the same for both. And there is a, this is a natural requirement in a database that structures should be unique. So we introduced an additional field called stereodescriptor. And here, this compound has a racemic value. This is resolved 1, and this is resolved 2. Let's speak a little about synthesis schemes. These are basic things. A simple synthesis is a linear one. You start with a substance, make several transformations, and you get your end product. Speaking in a language of graphs, this is a line. A combinatorial synthesis uses different reagents at several stages, and you get a lot of end products, and the graph is a tree. There is another synthetic strategy called the convergent or Y synthesis, where you start with different starting materials, and at a certain stage of the synthesis, you couple them. This is an effective type of synthesis. This is also a tree, but an upside-down tree. A realistic scheme is like this. If you have purification steps or reagent recovery, then you have also loops in it. Such a complex picture is the result of a query. All the reactions connected to a certain project are queried. All nodes denote a compound. The arrows know the reaction. And this graph is assembled in less than a second. Another feature of our database is the assignment database. Marvin has a nice feature. You can attach data to atoms and even to bonds. And in our case, we attach chemical shifts, NMR chemical shifts to the atoms. And these can be stored in our database. And of course, these are chemically intelligent structures, so they can be searched by substructure search or other searches. I have some special thanks. Special thanks are due to our colleagues, my colleagues, the chemistry project leaders, the IT project leaders, the help in administration, the IT support, and at last but not least, the 200 users, because such a big database would be a lifeless, dry thing without the users. And I thank you for your attention.